New at 6, Colorado may be the craft brew capital of the U.S., but there is a new movement brewing.
So people tired of New Year's Day hangovers, binge drinking culture. This new movement includes terms like dry January and sober curious. Denver 7's Jacqueline Allen found it's gaining traction with social drinkers just looking for a fresh start in 2020.
Today we're going to be doing the spiced honey spritz.
You don't have to call it a mocktail.
We kind of coined it as zero-proof cocktails.
But at Union Station's next-door eatery, several mixed drinks are now spirit-free.
That is delicious. No alcohol.
No, it does not have any alcohol.
Catering to a growing clientele.
I think there's a better life out there.
Like Jessica Zubert, taking a break from Denver's drinking culture.
Those are some people in my sober group.
She recently started a sober and social meetup group.
We had a sober Thanksgiving. A ton of people showed up. This is my book club, axe throwing.
It's good to be sober for that.
Her group is just part of a movement exploring a new kind of sobriety.
It's something that used to be a taboo where people, if you weren't a drinker, if you had to quit, you had a problem.
That idea is gaining ground with social drinkers who don't consider themselves alcoholics, but may do dry January, swearing off alcohol for a month. One study shows people who did that were still drinking less 6 months later.
There's this idea that sober sucks, right? And party's the fun word.
It's the reason Duke Rumley started his Denver nonprofit for the so-called Sober Curious.
And that's why we came up with the name Sober AF Entertainment. Safe. If it was just called Sober Entertainment, nobody would show up.
With discounted tickets to big music and sporting events, he says plenty of people want fun without alcohol.
People are looking for alternatives besides being around whiskey drunk guy.
There seems to be a big need for this.
Emily Schrader is the executive director with Bar Zero, an alcohol-free catering nonprofit that threw a sober New Year's Eve bash downtown and has several events planned for this month.
They might find that they feel so much better without alcohol and might decide to continue that in the future.
It's been pretty cool.
For people like Jessica, the chance to be sober and social is something she can raise her zero-proof cocktail glass to.
It's not easy. It's very challenging, but the benefits definitely outweigh the difficulties.
Jacqueline Allen, Denver 7.